Miss Renee Show. Miss Renee Show. Where we at? Miss Renee Show. I said, where we at, y'all? Miss Renee Show. Where we at, y'all? Hey, where we at, y'all? Right here on Georgia Avenue. Oh, yeah. We right here, y'all. We gon' sing right here. Yeah, Miss Renee. Oh, yeah. We gon' do it here. Right here, listen, vision, y'all. Oh, yeah. Miss Renee. I like how you sing it. Girl, I like how you sing it.
Thank you, Mustafa.
And where we at now?
Miss Renee Show.
If they didn't know it.
Thank you, Mustafa.
Hey, hey, you're welcome, man.
Miss Renee Show.
Make sure y'all tune in.
Miss Renee Show.
Yeah, tune in.
Miss Renee Show.
Yeah, tune in.
Miss Renee Show.
Oh, yeah. I need you to tune in.
Miss Renee Show.
We just getting started, but tune in, y'all.
Miss Renee Show.
In a minute, we gonna have to leave, but.
You're listening to Sharice Jones and Mustafa Captain. Soul Star. Thank you for tuning in. I love you. I want the show to end. God bless you. Stay tuned for H.O. Bonner, our power.
Okay. Let's go.
Miss Renee Show.
Hello and welcome to the Renee Allen and Friends Show. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's a beautiful day in the nation's capital. We are here across from Howard University. HU, you know, yes. I'm so excited. It's just a beautiful atmosphere and beautiful people. And I love WLVS and just the quality people and the wonderful, just superb, outstanding service that they provide. I mean, walking in here from my 9 to 5, y'all, yes, my 9 to 5, and they just have everything ready. You know, Kyle, Jacob, Morgan, Jeremy, the whole crew. Yes, give it up for the crew, y'all. Woohoo! I love them. Anyway, we were dancing to I'm Every Woman. It's, you know, it's her story month, right? They say history, Women's History Month. I say Women's Her Story Month, right? Because it's about all women, right? Okay, well, look, let's get this started. I want to first say, wow, it has been a wonderful weekend. I did not get any sleep. So I want to share with you a few pictures. Should we start with Shayna first? It's Shayna Colangelo's birthday, my niece. She used to be here at Listen Vision Live. She's out in LA doing her thing. Bam, boom, pat out. That's my niece. It's her birthday. Everybody say happy birthday. Yes. So happy birthday, Shayna. And I just want to honor my mother, Charlotte Frazier in Connecticut, my sister, Lisa Frazier, Sonia Frazier, you know, and all the people, all the women across America in honor of Women's Her Story Month. So thank you. Now I wanted to, there's my mom. Yes. And that's my eldest niece, Amber. Doesn't she look like Gabrielle Union? Yes. Yes. Bing, Amber, Grayson. That's what I say. Well, let's get started. I'm being silly. Look, I had so many things happen this weekend, but two in particular I was so ecstatic about. And one was, I was on a show called Elite Conversations, and I met this wonderful guy, Daryl. I mean, Trevor Ott's friend to the show, Darlene Brown, friend to the show, someone else. Everyone kept saying, Daryl Spears. I finally met him. I was honored to be on his inaugural show of Elite Conversations out in Laurel, the community, Village community. There he is in the black jacket with the next to me, to the left. And let me tell you, he had a wonderful inaugural Prince George's County Business Summit and Entrepreneurs Night at Bohanka Volkswagen in Capitol Heights. I mean, when I tell you it was phenomenal, it was all that. They had all types of, if you want to get your headshot, professional headshot, they had all of the different awesome businesses. Remax Supreme was there, Chick-fil-A. Just like, I don't have the list with me, but it was just a phenomenal. And one particular person I met, it was, you know, I love to putt mini golf. So this gentleman was Harvey Johnson. I think he's watching today too. Hi, Harvey. And it is the Golf Adventures. And let me tell you, it's going to blow up, y'all. I'm going to have him here as soon as I can tie him down. And you're going to see they're just, you know, mini golf course, you know, just mobile. It's phenomenal. I had a ball. So let's go on to some of the events that are going on now. Oh, no, the Black CEO, I forgot about it. Look, friend to the show, Trevor Oz, also had, there he is, and his mini me right there, Trevor's young guy. He is like a mini Black CEO. And it was a three-day series in Laurel again, and it was just phenomenal. I had people with the likes of George C. Frazier of the Power Networking Conference. By the way, that's in July. Get your tickets. It always runs out. And you can find George C. Frazier, no Z, no I, F-R-A-S-E-R, like my maiden name, on Facebook, our Power Networking Conference, and it will change your life. Forbes magazine says it is one of the top five conferences not to miss. Not five Black conferences, one of the five top conferences not to miss. And I haven't missed it in 5 years. So there's an event tomorrow, my dear friend Janice McLean Deloach, and they call her the next Oprah Winfrey, and that's her annual black tie red carpet gala, which will be at the Holiday Inn. I'm thinking Howard Inn right around the corner, y'all. I'm around all this historical just fabulosity. But it's the Holiday Inn on Lombard Street. It's tomorrow, and it's going to be from 6 until 9:30. I am one of the hosts, and I'm excited to be there with her. She's phenomenal. She just wrote a book, The Diary, I believe, of an Entrepreneur, the autobiography of an entrepreneur, and it's just awesome. She has so many pictures of so many people. She had a picture of Kanye before he was Kanye West. I mean, it's just, she's just extraordinary. So another thing we're going to be having is Sisters for Sisters Network. You know, I'm the secretary, historian, and official MC, chair of mentoring and the veterans outreach, and we are celebrating our 15th year anniversary this year at the Power Networking Conference as well. And we have a Sisters for Sisters Circle, March 14th, my mother's birthday. I won't be here. I'll be out. I won't be here for that. But I want you to come and see Peggy Morris and all the wonderful people. And just look her up on Facebook for Sisters, the number 4 Sisters Network Incorporated. Another wonderful event. You know, Remy Dula J, she is a wonderful, right now I believe she's in Nigeria, and she's having an event that's empowering women and men. And why I think this is so important is because there's a lot of, you know, especially with Hillary and things that were happening over the past 4 years in the election campaign, you know, it was all about women, and I'm about women, don't get me wrong, but this is the first conference that I've heard locally that's for women and men's empowerment, and I like that. We can't leave the men out, right? Right, ladies? Anybody in here? Yes. So her, do you have her flyer? That's Remy, and I'm actually her MC, but she's been doing this for a while. She brought the actual Her Majesty and His Majesty from Nigeria last summer. It was just phenomenal. It was phenomenal. So then we have, of course, the Mrs. DC America pageant, and that is a friend to the show and my sister girl, Raquel Riley Thomas, and the People's MC, which is myself, and the voice of DC, Rick Bernstein, will be hosting this event on March 18th. And there still are some tickets, but it always sells out as well, y'all. I'm around some fabulous people. And this is going to be, I believe, at the Italy, the embassy of Italy, but it's one of the embassies, and it's going to be wonderful. So just look it up on Eventbrite. We have so many things going on. Okay, oh, Meet Me Monday. My girl, Micheline, will be here next week. We've been back and forth. You know, she's always traveling, and she's taking her Meet Me Monday all over the globe. I think she'll be in Charlotte. Is that the one for Charlotte? She's just, yeah, April 3rd. She's just moving and grooving, but she will be here live in the studio on March 8th, and you don't want to miss it. She is a hoot. She's just exquisite. I love her. Hopefully our mutual friend, Sonia Lowry will come and spend some time in the studio with us as well. Okay, I think that's about it. You know, I just want to bring some things to you and have a little fun. But we have some great guests. We have designer Vivian Anya by Vivian. She is, I believe, from Nigeria. She just finished launching her beautiful line in New York, New York Fashion Week, and she'll be here planning to attend the DC Fashion Week. And I also have celebrity photographer Renee Toot, I believe, Will Height, and I'm going to bring her up next. So don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. But listen to Morgan Johnson. She's one of WLVS's own, and I launched her music on my show, debuted it on my show, and it's called No Curfew, and I hope you enjoy it. I'll be right back.
I feel good right now on
Miss Renee Show.
Yeah.
Miss Renee Show. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I said my stop.
Miss Renee Show.
I say Mustafa,
we on a Miss Renee Show.
I say Mustafa,
Miss Renee Show.
Here's Morgan Johnson, no curfew.
Miss Renee Show.
On the set. Hello and welcome back to the Renee Allen and Friends Show. That was Morgan Johnson, one of my favorites here at WLVS with No Curfew. I'm telling you, I love that song. Do you love it? And you love it? Did you love it?
I love it. Beautiful.
I'm sitting here. My goodness, we had some fun at that Prince George's County Business Summit, didn't we?
We did.
But I've been meaning to meet you. Copa Styles publisher, Rodney Wayne Brandt, has talked about you for so long, because Renee and Renee, right?
Right, that's right.
But of course, it just takes great people to bring people together, right?
Absolutely.
So I actually met up with her at the Business Summit.
Yes.
And I love your spirit, your karma.
Right.
You know, you take so much time and pride in your pictures. And pictures, you know, they last forever. People really want
That's
a good
right.
picture, right?
That's right?
And so I wanted to bring her here and share her with you, because I've seen her repertoire. She has diverse clients. She does diverse photography. She really loves what she does. And if you can put, Kyle, that picture of her back up, we're going to read what that says, because I loved this. I loved it. Life is like a camera. Focus on what's important, capture the good times, develop from the negative, and if things don't work out, take another shot.
Bam! That's
boom,
right.
Ka-dam. I love it.
Oh. Yes, absolutely.
I love
absolutely.
It. Yes. So I could read that a couple of times a day. It gets me pumped up, right?
Yes.
So let's talk about you, Renee.
Okay.
You know, what catapulted you up into the life of the camera?
And the camera?
Yes. How did that happen?
Well, I'll try to make this real short. I used to be a beauty consultant, and I used to go around and take in headshots of people, not on a professional level.
Mm-hmm.
And I just fell in love with the creativity mm-hmm. and being able to make people look wonderful and feel mm-hmm. wonderful. And absolutely, it just birthed in me. More mm-hmm. and more and more, my desire, my hunger just grew. I purchased my first professional camera for
$10.
How that happened was, I was at work, and one of my coworkers lost her sunglasses at the Lost and Found at the Smithsonian.
Mm-hmm.
So when she went back to look for them, she noticed all these cameras. And so she said, "What are you going to do with them?" So the guy said, "You can have them if you want." So
wow.
she came back to work with shopping bags full of cameras, and I bought my first professional camera. Didn't know what I was getting, but I knew that I wanted to increase my knowledge. I wanted to do more and more and more. So that started, and that's been 17 years ago.
Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Brought you a
Absolutely.
Camera for $10.
$10, my first professional camera.
And they're about $1,000.
Absolutely. Very expensive.
Yeah, see. So how long have you been doing it?
17 years.
Oh, you did say mm-hmm. that. Wow, you don't even look like you've been doing this 17 years.
That's
Will
17
you look at her,
years.
Y'all? No, I don't think so. I think you're telling me a fib. You look
so
good, girl.
Thank you.
You do.
So do you.
Thank you. So what's the name of your company, first of all?
It's RM Photography, Capturing Your Moment.
I love it. I love it.
Because Capturing Your Moment, it's not just a slogan,
mm-hmm.
but it's truly my passion, and that's what I enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm inspired by from the great to the least.
Yeah.
You know, I can do window shopping and get inspired and come up with ideas, look at people and circumstances and situations, and just want to create a memory for someone.
Mm-hmm.
That's important to me, to create memories.
I know it is.
Yeah.
I know
yeah.
it is. I can feel your passion.
Oh,
you watching her speak about it. Can't you feel the passion? This is what I love about
mm-hmm.
you.
Thank
you know?
You.
So what's next for you? What are some things you're involved in now or going to be doing?
Well, I'm so excited that I'm now a part of the Copa Style magazine.
Yes.
Team.
Copa Style.
Yes, I'm loving that. And that's taking me to a whole new different
mm-hmm.
dimension in my photography.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's awesome. Two of the things that I really want to do is mm-hmm. next year open up a photography camp for kids.
Nice.
And give them something to do
mm-hmm.
Throughout the summer months, and help
mm-hmm.
their parents with the timing, with things, you know, kids
mm-hmm.
doing it. So I'm bored. But now they can use their skills. A lot of kids love photography. And so I want to do a camp for kids for photography.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I'm happy to hear that, because
yeah.
my son Chase will
mm-hmm.
be one of your first kids.
Awesome.
Because he's always taking pictures with his camera, and he sends
right.
them to me. Mom, look at this. Look
yeah,
at that.
Absolutely.
So I love that.
Yeah. And that's how it begins.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just that desire. And when it grows and it becomes a passion, it's all you think, eat, everything. That's what you love.
Eat,
and
sleep.
Everything. Photography. So I'm very, very passionate about it. And
mm-hmm.
sharing what I know with other people. I always said it's good to have a mentor and to be a mentee to someone else.
Yes.
To let them grow and experience. Not all
mm-hmm.
photographers are alike. We have
mm-hmm.
our different styles, but we can learn definitely from one another and
mm-hmm.
share.
Yeah.
Well, what a nice segue about sharing, because she actually volunteered to come here, take some pictures, be a part of the studio and the Renee Allen Friend Show today, which I'm ecstatic about. So thank you so much.
Oh,
thank
you're very welcome.
And anything you want to just tell the viewers about photography, or maybe a tip or two before we go to the next segment?
Well, I will tell you that photography isn't expensive. It's priceless, because the memories last.
There you have it. Renee Tutt Wilhite. I got it right that time, sister. Yes. So how can they get a hold of you, Renee?
I can be reached on Facebook, social media, of course, and that's Renee Tutt Wilhite, W-I-L-H-I-T-E. Or I'm on Instagram at R-M Photography M-D.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Oh,
I appreciate
welcome.
You, sis.
You're welcome.
And we'll be right back with designer Vivian. Now, I'm going to get that last name right in a minute, but it's Anya by Vivian. We'll be right back. Stay right there. Oh, and my girl Silver Logan Sharp. I think she's about to come on. She was my first guest over 2 years ago. We're kind of celebrating our two-year anniversary today, kind of a pre-celebration to something we're going to be doing with WLVS. But Silver Logan Sharp, one of my favorite singers, the former singer of Chic. Remember Freak Out? Yes. Mm-hmm. Remember that?
Absolutely.
So I hope you enjoy it. It's called Find Me. Thank you. I love it. I love it. Welcome back to the Renee Allen and Friends Show. I'm sitting here with New York Fashion Week's finest.
All right.
Yes. And I'm going to try to get her name right. Vivian Apacopa.
Yay.
Yay.
Good job. You're amazing.
Yeah, thank you so much. You're amazing. I love your designs. I love your fashion. I love
your
personality.
Thank you.
Let's tell the WLVS listeners about you. Who is Vivian?
Vivian. My name is Vivian Awakova, like she said correctly.
Yeah.
I am a fashion designer based in the D.C. area. I launched my label called Anya by Vivian in 2013. Yes. So since then, it's been growing, and it's really been doing phenomenal. And I am so surprised and excited about where it is going.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, well, what we're looking at some of your designs now. The WLVS listeners are actually seeing those. I love your designs. What inspired you? I mean, it's such a vibrant, beautiful, elegant line. What's your inspiration?
See, you just got the word. Elegance is always something that comes to me whenever I design my clothing. And sometimes elegance is not just about what you're wearing. It's about the way you carry yourself.
Mm.
Because beauty comes from within.
Ooh, yes.
And so what we do is make you look more beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And our tagline is beautiful in every form, meaning that no matter what your size, your figure, your height, we would just make it right. We'll make you feel confident. And you know, to be honest with you, what typically inspires me is a woman's beautiful body.
Wow.
The uniqueness of every woman.
Yes.
When I look at a woman and I just look at, especially when they're like, oh, I love what you're wearing, but it's not going to look good on me. I'm like, no, you haven't met me. I want to make it look good on you. Okay.
Yes.
So that is what really inspires me. But sometimes, you know, when I'm sitting and sketching, you know, and a concept comes into my head, I would usually just, put it down, because this is a gift. It's not, this is something that God has blessed me with. So it does come very natural to me. I could be doing something else, talking in the shower, whatever I'm doing, and something comes up to my head. I just come out and I have my sketch pad everywhere in the house. And I just put it down so I don't forget.
Yeah.
And that's where I start to build. You know, that concept. And then when it gets to fabric is something else that I just love fabric. It doesn't matter, you know, what kind of fabric it is. It is, I love texture, I love prints, you know, I just love fabric. When I go to a fabric store, I am like a kid in Toys R Us. You have no idea. You have to literally pull me out. And it doesn't matter whether it's a print or a delicate French lace, you know, whatever it is. I'm just thinking of what I can do with it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just an exciting and passionate feeling that I get when I'm doing this. And I'm very thankful and grateful to God that I'm able to follow my passion and achieve my dreams.
Oh, we are too. And you know, when you spoke about when you get that feeling and you get your piece of paper start writing, isn't that God talking
it
to you?
It is God talking
that,
to
that's
me.
That's God, and you better listen, because you'll forget it like that.
Exactly. Yeah.
Well, when you first walked into this studio, mm-hmm. and I looked over at that door, I said, she looks like she's walking in on a runway.
Oh. Thank you, you're very kind.
You brought just that runway walk and the look. I mean, I love the angles and the, you have so many different, let's talk about this outfit.
Thank you.
There's so many different, there's pleats, there's the balloons, there's look. I love it. So talk about this.
So this is one of our latest pieces for mm-hmm. our 2017 collection.
I love it.
And it just tells the story of mm-hmm. what I do without me having to speak about mm-hmm. it. And when I look at it, it just, it's all about the time I spend mm-hmm. creating a piece mm-hmm. and thinking about who's going to wear it and how it's going to look on the person. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people like to wear something that I love, you know, being minimalistic, and that is what my style is. It's minimalistic, mm-hmm. but it's chic, mm-hmm. you know, I'm very yes. elegant, you know, so I don't need a lot of foo-foo and all that stuff, just simple, nice. This sleeve is so, it just gives me life, just
I
looking
love it.
At it,
yeah.
But it's all in the details, you know, mm-hmm. when I sketch it and I put add this puff to it. I have another version of it where the puff is a little bit bigger than this one, but it depends on the occasion
yeah.
that you're going to. This is our signature look for the season. Mm. We just have
I wear
these
flowers all the time.
Little
so
flowers
have
in almost all our clothes
yes.
for, that we design.
Yes.
And this would show up in our ready-to-wear collection mm. because we do ready-to-wear mm-hmm. and we have our couture line.
Mm.
Yes. So clients come to me and we discuss, you know, whatever their needs mm-hmm. are. Sometimes it goes from talking about fashion to talking about personality to yeah. confidence to empowerment.
Wow, that's what I'm talking about.
Yes. And, you know, I find myself in these conversations uh-huh. and I'm like, you know, whatever it is that, you know, God is using this gift, you know, to do for me and for people around me, mm-hmm. you know, to bless other people. There are so many women who are yeah. walking around who don't have great self-esteem, and not because of anything they did, but right. nobody ever told them they were that beautiful.
Right.
And when I see these women, these are the people I spend more time with, mm-hmm. you know, and, you know, just show them, tell them the parts of their body that is so beautiful and we can showcase. And they're like, oh, nobody's ever told me that. I'm like, okay, better know it now, you know,
yeah.
because every woman is beautiful, every
yeah.
woman. And we as women need to continue to support and, you know, just
yeah.
kind of encourage other women and not bring them down, because bringing people down does affect them in ways we don't know.
I love what you're saying right now.
Yeah.
You know, being the oldest of three girls, my mm-hmm. pecking order, I really don't have a choice but to be that type of person, you know. Where do you fall in the pecking order of your family, your siblings?
I am I'm in the middle.
Okay, like my
yeah.
sister Lisa.
All right, stuck in the
you're
middle.
You trying to grab mommy and daddy, right?
Right,
they got the
right,
young one. But,
right.
you know, seriously, when you talk about I believe you when you were talking about helping women.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, and well, how do you feel about this? I know about fashion, but you just touched on some things and my heartstrings are pulling. So, you know, what do you think about the women who, you know, throw the shade, throw the hate, or just, you know, and what do you think we can do about that? Or what do you think that we should do about that to help women to love themselves?
Well, that's the key, you know, about women loving themselves.
Mm-hmm.
There's a shade thing that people do. And when you see someone trying to throw a shade, which is sometimes being mean,
yeah.
that's what it is. Just a nice
mean girls.
Yeah, mean way mm-hmm. of talking to someone mm-hmm. is to bring the person down so that they can feel better.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? You just have to work within yourself first.
Yeah.
Because you cannot predict how the next person is going to treat you.
Mm-hmm.
So when you work with yourself and tell yourself, I am beautiful, regardless, you don't even need anyone to tell you that. Look in the mirror, say that to yourself every day.
Yes.
I am beautiful no matter my color, no matter my size, no matter whatever,
yeah.
you know, my socioeconomic status.
Mm-hmm.
I am just a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
And so no matter what people say to you, it just kind of just bounces off,
Dougie,
you know,
Dougie.
Exactly. But it's a lot of work. It's not
yeah.
easy. I know it's not easy. It's easier said than done.
Mm-hmm.
But when you do it consistently over years,
yes,
you know, and not allow yourself to be brought down by people,
mm-hmm.
the best you can do is walk away from not put yourself in the same space with people who don't treat you right. But guess what?
What?
There are so many people in the world who will treat you right.
Yes!
So just walk away and find those people yes. who love you. And yes. that's all you need around you.
I love it. Look, I have to bring you to a sister's... look, we have an organization, Women Helping Women to Correct Connect. Oh, yeah. mm-hmm. And that's Sisters for Sisters Network. Yes. And I was just talking about the last segment. Mm-hmm. But I really want to bring you as a guest of mine.
That would
because
be wonderful.
Everything you spoke about yes. Is really... a part of Sisters for Sisters Network.
Right.
It's just women helping women to connect. And whether you have a GED, a PhD, a right. 501c3, they want women to get to the next level. So yes. I want you to come because I want people to know your designs too.
Oh, that would be wonderful. That would be awesome. That would be awesome.
So let's talk about what's next for you. New York, New York Fashion Week. That's huge. Let's talk about that.
Out of the body experience for me. You know, I've been doing this. Like I told you earlier, I've been doing this since I was 11.
Mm.
I taught myself how to sew.
I don't think you told me that, or I didn't hear it at 11.
Oh, I probably said it so much. I didn't tell you that. Yeah, I taught myself how to make clothes. I grew up an introverted child, very introverted, but it was just by nature. I just found myself just being in one room, just either cutting up a piece of something or working with my mom's, you know, leftover fabrics. Mm-hmm. And then my father recognized that I really had this talent. And the first little crop top that I made as a child, he just went all over telling people, did you see what my daughter did? He was my first fan.
I love it.
He was so proud. My mom was providing the resource. She's
yes.
not as vocal in terms of being yes. mushy mushy, but my dad was like, oh my God, when we had neighbors come over, mm-hmm. they'd be like, okay, why don't you wear that outfit so they can see it?
Wow.
He talked about it so much, I'm like, oh, okay, that's nice.
We're going to give a little shout out to the parents here.
Yes, yes, it's very important. You never know what dads can do for their kids in their lives.
Well, you know, dads and their girls.
They are just
moms and their boys.
Yes.
Right? I saw something on Facebook about that earlier today.
Yeah,
right?
that was my dad.
Yeah.
So it's, but then eventually I went to a fashion school to kind of, you know, just make it formal, formalize my craft.
Mm-hmm.
And I've done a couple businesses here and there way back when I lived in Nigeria, but here it's a different level.
Now, how long have you been here and do you now reside here?
I live here, yes. Okay. I've been living here for the past 15 years.
Wow.
Yeah, but within those 15 years, I have, you know, God has been kind. I've had the opportunity to travel around the world mm-hmm. to be able to see mm-hmm. what is happening in the world mm-hmm. and be able to navigate this industry
wow.
the right way. And
that's a blessing.
Even before I launched the label, mm-hmm. I was already in the background doing my research, doing my work. So it's not just 3 years ago. This is a lifetime
yes.
that I've been preparing myself and God has been preparing me for this time.
Preparation, right.
So here we are, 2017 in New York.
Woo!
I was
yes!
like, this is not real. Is this happening? I mean, it was so wonderful. It was so out of body. I'm still in cloud nine. Anytime I talk about it.
I am too for you.
You know, just being in the backstage, you know, seeing all these 200 to 300 models. Mm. I'm like, okay, in D.C., I have like 10, 15 models, but 200.
That's a lot, too.
Oh, my God. You're just like selecting who you need to mm-hmm. carry. You could see the pictures that we sent.
Yeah, gorgeous.
I mean,
gorgeous.
It was all these beautiful girls, you know, pageant queens. Mm-hmm. They were just, I've never seen so much beauty in my life.
Wow.
It was amazing.
Well, you just look in the mirror.
Then the media, the mm-hmm. the coverage, the everything. It was just so nice. So
you have to send me a picture or two so next week I can kind of show them what we're talking about.
Right,
because
right.
I normally have my pictures. They're going to be like, Renee, where's the picture of that? You know. So we're going to share something with you next week. Yes.
And we're putting up some of those on our Instagram
Good. Well, tell them how to get a hold of you, Vivian.
Yes, we do have an online boutique, mm-hmm. www.anyabyvivian.com. Anya is A-N-Y-A. Mm-hmm. And in my language, it means vision.
I love it.
It's about the way I see beauty. So mm-hmm. that is a symbolic, it's my first name.
You
Who
know, named
my
your dad?
Name.
The dad name?
My
you?
Dad, of course. So that's where the name originated from. Mm-hmm. So it means vision is supreme. It's the way I see things, you know, and I see beauty in everybody. And
that was a divine order there.
Yes.
You know?
Yes. I didn't have to look far to find the name that mm-hmm. meant something, you know, very close to my heart.
Yes. And Vivian is V-I-V-I-E-N. want to make sure we don't have it right.
That's right. You got it, girl.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're on Facebook. It's Anya by Vivian. And on Instagram, at Anya by Vivian. Again, it's AnyaByVivian.
Yes. Well, you know, time is flying. It's already, oh, my goodness. But, you know, anything you want to say to the viewers? I mean, we're in 130 countries, a quarter of a million viewers. Right. You know, just is there anything you want to say about fashion or anyone who might be at Howard University and wants to get into fashion? Or what would you like to say to the woman who wants to start her career in your footsteps?
I am actually currently working with, good thing you mentioned Howard, with a few students over there. I'm mentoring them. Two of them are interning with
me.
And for me, it's a personal thing. It's almost, it's just like trying to, almost like a mother taking care of her children, just trying to, you know, imbibe and teach and help them to, you know, nurture them to come up and do the right things in life. So I do have that connection with these young women. I have two beautiful daughters as well who are looking up to me and what I do. They do model for me too.
Awesome.
I don't pay them. Don't tell them.
You pay them in other ways, right?
And we're having a wonderful fashion show coming up March 11th.
Yes, we have a flyer too, Kyle. Yes,
there you go.
So tell us about that. Yes.
This year, we do this every year since I launched my label. Every spring, we do have this fashion show. This year is going to be different.
Yes.
We're going to have a band, a live band, with a friend, musician, Lynette. Uh-huh. We're going to be collaborating with the Real Housewives of Potomac. Woo-hoo! They're going to be supplying the hair for the models, Miss Karen Huger.
Yes.
And then Miss Cherise Jackson Jordan is going to be walking my runway in my outfit. It'll be her first time.
Wow.
So it's very exciting. Please go to Eventbrite, get your tickets, and come and join us and have fun.
I will be there. I will be there. Thank you for the invitation. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you
are
so
exquisite and just the epitome of elegance.
Thank you so much. Yes. You too. You're beautiful.
Thank you. So we'll be right back. I'm going to show you a picture of, now you know our resident chef, Chef Terrence Williams, 2 Fish and 5 Loaves Barbecue. He's always feeding us. He was just on Great Morning Washington. He just is just a phenomenal chef, always spoiling us. And I believe he has some macaroni and cheese, chicken and waffles. Woohoo! Yes! Thank you, Kyle. Kyle's on top of things. And we also have the pop star and songwriter, Stephanie Mathias. And she is here to perform live. I met her at the Copa Style 2017 Man of the Year with my dear friend Walter Kirkland, and we had a wonderful time at Sobeys Restaurant and Lounge of my also friends to the show, Josette Simpson, who's on the show, and her husband Tony, and we're just gonna walk on over here and we are going to meet her and talk to the chef, and so I'll see you in a few minutes.
Thank you.
All right. Is this on? It's on? Okay, good. All right. So, Chef, well, you come on over. How you doing? Look, this is almost the end of the show. We have a good 7 minutes, and the camera's right there, y'all, just so you know. And so we have our resident chef, Chef Terrence Williams of 2 Fish and 5 Loaves Barbecue. He has a new logo. Did you see it? Did you check it out? Wasn't it awesome? Bam, boom, pa-dow. Yes. So tell us about that.
Well, I just got tired of people. My old logo was nice, but people kept reading across. So they would say 2-5 fish loaves. So I got kind of tired of people doing that. So I made a decision to redesign the logo.
And I'm so glad you did, because I was one of those people always messing it up. So you didn't see me messing it up today, did you, Chef? So what do you have today for us? I think I already told him.
I just want to wish you a happy 2-year anniversary.
Oh, thank you.
Love you.
Oh, I love you back.
And today we have chicken and waffles, mini chicken and waffles with a strawberry puree with that goes on there with that. And then you also got my famous macaroni and cheese cups to go along with that.
I love those. Y'all ought to come down to the studio one.
want to come and check out this food, or better yet, how can they get a hold of you so they can get their own food?
That's right. TwoFishPhilosBBQ.com. And that's the same thing on all social media platforms, TwoFishPhilosBBQ.
Yes, yes. Get that food, y'all. I took some home last Thanksgiving and Christmas, and now they want the ribs. They want everything every time I leave, right? Yeah. So I'm telling you, once you start ordering it, you're going to be like, my finger looking good. So look, I want you to help me introduce this one, because she is a pop artist, and she is a songwriter, a pianist, and you're getting ready to launch your new EP, you called it, right?
Yeah.
And where is that at? Now, you can talk into this, I believe.
Hello.
Yeah, hello. So you're going to be launching that where?
At the Epicure Cafe in Fairfax, Virginia, mm-hmm. on March 11th at 8:30 p.m.
Yes, and we have a mutual dear friend who I'm going to invite to the show the latter part of the month. Sadiq, can you talk about your collaboration with him?
Well, yeah. Actually, he is he's no longer opening my show. It's he has a work trip coming up that same weekend, so I've got another gal coming up. But Nassim is awesome. Yeah. So when he is on the show, he'll be amazing.
Yes. Well, we want to hear, is it Sweet Baby?
Yes.
Yes. So we're going to hear live from Stephanie Mathias, Sweet Baby, right here on WLVS Renee Allen and Friends Show for the first time, or one of the first times, in the DMV area. Stephanie Mathias, enjoy. Yes.
I don't know.
I just wanted to say hi before you left the building. Mwah. Love you. That was awesome.
Thank you so much.
Her EP, CD, album, however you want to put it, is called Fragile, and that's Sweet Sweet Baby. I love it. I'm going to get one tonight. And thank you for coming to launch that and debut it on the Renee Allen and Friends Show. Oh, you have you. A beautiful voice.
Thank you so much. This song is actually available on iTunes right now.
Really? So yes. Tell them how to get a hold of everything.
So, yeah. So go to iTunes, and you can look up Sweet Baby by Stephanie Mathias. M-A-T-H-I-A-S. And also you can look at my website, stephaniemathias.com. I'm on Facebook, Stephanie Mathias Music.
Well, Stephanie Mathias is on her way highest.
Yes! Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, yes. Thank you so much for tuning in to Renee Allen and Friends Show. Stay tuned for the Hour of Power, my dear friend, Dr. H.L. Barter. And I'm getting ready to have some of this 2 fish and 5 loaves barbecue, y'all. Cuckoo! See ya! Did you turn it off already? Because we have Micheline Bowman coming in next week. We have the Mrs. DC Pageant contestants, yes, coming next week. So you tune in there, okay? Love you, bye.